One final principle I wanted to put out there before we start getting our hands dirty with actually converting this design into a template is the idea that every element in HTML is a box. So if we go to the Chrome browser, we have the last version of our example here, and we can right-click on any element to inspect it. So I just right-clicked and selected the Inspect Element item here. And what that will do is show us on the left-hand side the HTML structure of our page. This should look pretty familiar to you. This is what we've been creating inside of our editor. And on the right-hand side, we have the styles for our element, which we can actually edit here in line, which we'll do a lot in this series. If we go back over to the left side and we hover over an element, you can see how it gets highlighted. So here's our heading tag. Here's our paragraph tag. And you can see that there's a blue box with an orange box above and below it. Over here on the right-hand side, you can see that we have this box. As we hover over different layers of this box, we see the different colors highlighted. So here's our blue that we were just looking at. And if we go all the way out to the outside margin, you can see the orange. So what this is doing is showing us the various layers around the box that is our element. So the middle part here, the blue part, is the element itself, the size of it. You can see that it stretches all the way across, which is 1,264 pixels, and then it's 16 pixels tall. Around this box, we can define some padding, some border, and the margin. The border and padding aren't defined. You can see that there's no green or yellow highlighted in the browser as we hover over these, but there's some margin defined. Now, every element on every web page is actually a box like this, with these different properties, all of which we'll explore later on in this series. But I find it very helpful when thinking about how to style an element to realize that it's a box and that we're just adjusting the box and what's around it and what's inside of it. Okay, I think that it's time that we start applying these principles we've been talking about in actually beginning to convert our template.